Om Namah Shivaya. Hi friends, how are you? In this video, we are going to learn about the glycolysis. Glycolysis is derived from the Greek words glycos means sweet or sugar and lysis means dissolution. It is a universal pathway in the living cells, and the complete pathway of glycolysis was elucidated in 1914. This pathway is often referred to as Emden-Meyerhof pathway or EM pathway in the honor of two biochemists who made a major contribution to the knowledge of glycolysis. Next, glycolysis definition. Glycolysis is defined as a sequence of reactions converting the glucose to pyruvate or lactate with the production of ATP. Glycolysis is defined as the sequence of reactions converting the glucose or glycogen to pyruvate or lactate with the production of ATP. Next, silent features of the glycolysis. Silent features of glycolysis. First, glycolysis takes place in all cells of the body. The enzyme of this pathway are present in the cytosol fraction of the cells. Glycolysis occurs in the absence of oxygen, we call anaerobic reaction, or in the presence of oxygen, we call aerobic reaction. Lactate is the end product under anaerobic condition. In aerobic condition, pyruvate is formed, which is then oxidized to carbon dioxide and water. Next, glycolysis is a major pathway for ATP synthesis in tissues lacking mitochondria. And the examples that lacking the mitochondria are erythrocytes, cornea, and lens. For remembering this, remember as cell. CEL. C means cornea, E means erythrocytes, and L means lens. Okay, next. Glycolysis is very essential for brain, which is dependent on glucose for energy. The glucose in brain has to undergo the glycolysis before it is oxidized to carbon dioxide and H2O. Glycolysis is very essential for brain, which is dependent on glucose for energy. The glucose in brain has to undergo the glycolysis before it is oxidized to carbon dioxide and water. And glycolysis, that is anaerobic reaction, may be summarized by the NAT reaction, that is glucose plus 2 ADP plus 2 inorganic phosphate, that gives the 2 lactate and 2 ATP. That means glucose converted to the 2 lactate and 2 ADP and 2 inorganic phosphate converting to the 2 ATP. Next, glycolysis is the central metabolic pathway, with many of its intermediates providing branch point of other pathways. Thus, the intermediates of glycolysis are useful for the synthesis of amino acids and fat. The reversal of glycolysis along with the alternate arrangements of the irreversible steps will result in the synthesis of glucose, that is gluconeogenesis. Next, reactions of the glycolysis. The sequence of reactions of glycolysis is given in the figure. The pathway can be divided into three distinct pathways. This glycolysis pathway is divided into three distinct pathways or phases: energy investment phase, splitting phase, energy generation phase. These are the three distinct phases. First, energy investment phase. In first energy investment phase, glucose is phosphorylated to glucose 6-phosphate by hexokinase or glucokinase, and both these are isoenzymes. This is an irreversible reaction dependent on ATP and magnesium ion. The enzyme hexokinase is present in almost all the tissues. It catalyzes the phosphorylation of various hexoses, and these hexoses are fructose mannose and has low Km value for substrates about 0 to 1 millimolarity and is inhibited by glucose 6-phosphate. Next, glucokinase. Next about the glucokinase. glucokinase present in liver and catalyzes the phosphorylation of only glucose and has high Km value for glucose, that is 10 millimolarity, and is not inhibited by the glucose 6-phosphate. Due to high affinity, and the high affinity has a low Km value. Glucose is utilized by hexokinase even at low concentration of glucose, whereas glucokinase is utilized by hexokinase even at low concentration, whereas glucokinase acts only at the high levels of glucose after a meal when blood glucose concentration is above 100 mg per deciliter. Glucose 6-phosphate is impermeable to the cell membrane. It is a central molecule with a variety of metabolic fates, that is glycolysis, glycogenesis and gluconeogenesis and pentose phosphate pathway. See the flowchart. In first reaction, the glucose is converted to the glucose 6-phosphate. We call this reaction as phosphorylated reaction. And this reaction is dependent on the enzyme, and enzymes acted here are hexokinase and glucokinase, and this reaction is dependent on ATP and magnesium ion. Okay, glucose is converted to glucose 6-phosphate by the enzyme acting here are hexokinase and glucokinase, and this reaction is dependent on ATP and magnesium ion. Next, second reaction, glucose 6-phosphate undergoes the isomerization to give fructose 6-phosphate in the presence of enzyme phosphohexose isomerase and magnesium ion. Glucose 6-phosphate undergoes the isomerization to give the fructose 6-phosphate in the presence of enzyme phosphohexose isomerase and this reaction dependent on magnesium ion. And the second reaction is isomerization reaction. In this reaction, glucose 6-phosphate is converted to fructose 6-phosphate. See here, fructose 6-phosphate. And this reaction is done by the enzyme phosphohexose isomerase. Okay, this reaction is dependent on the enzyme phosphohexose isomerase. Next, fructose 6-phosphate is phosphorylated to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate by the enzyme phosphofructokinase. This is an irreversible and regulatory step in glycolysis. Okay, fructose 6-phosphate is phosphorylated to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate by the enzyme phosphofructokinase. This is an irreversible and regulatory step in glycolysis. See here, fructose 6-phosphate is converted to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate, and this reaction is done by the enzyme phosphofructokinase. In this reaction, ATP and magnesium ion are involved. This reaction is dependent on ATP and magnesium ion. And this reaction is irreversible and regulatory step of this pathway. Fructose 6-phosphate to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate. This reaction is irreversible and regulatory step of this pathway. Next, splitting phase. This is the second phase. The 6-carbon fructose 1,6-bisphosphate is split to 2,3-carbon compounds. That is glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate by the enzyme aldose. Here aldose means fructose 1,6-bisphosphate aldose. Next, in splitting phase, fructose 1,6-bisphosphate is converted to glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate in the presence of enzyme aldose. Okay, in the presence of enzyme aldose, fructose 1,6-bisphosphate is converted to glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate. This step also in splitting phase. The enzyme phosphotriose isomerase catalyzes the reversible interconversion of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Thus, two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate are obtained from one molecule of glucose. The enzyme phosphotriose isomerase catalyzes the reversible interconversion of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate. Thus, two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate are obtained from one molecule of glucose. See here, this is an interconversion reaction. In this reaction, this glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate and dihydroxyacetone phosphate are interconversion. Thus, in the presence of enzyme phosphotriose isomerase, this glyceraldehyde acetone phosphate is converted to the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. Thus, the two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate formed from only one molecule of glucose. Okay, thus the two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate are formed from only one molecule of glucose due to this interconversion of dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate in the presence of enzyme phosphotriose isomerase. Next, enzyme generation phase. Next, we are talking about the enzyme generation phase. Glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase converts glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate to 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. This step is important as it is involved with the formation of NADH plus H plus and M high energy compound, that is 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. And iodoacetate and arsenate inhibit the enzyme glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase. In aerobic condition, NADH passes through the electron transport chain and 6 ATP, that is 2 into 3, 6 ATP are synthesized by oxidative phosphorylation. See once again. In energy generation phase, glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase converts the glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate to 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. This step is important as it is involved in the formation of NADH plus H plus and M high energy compound 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate. Iodoacetate and arsenate inhibit the enzyme glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase. In aerobic condition, NADH passes through the electron transport chain and 6 ATP are synthesized by oxidative phosphorylation. Next, in energy generating phase, glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is converted to the 1,3-bisphosphoglycerate in the presence of enzyme glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate dehydrogenase. Okay, in this reaction, one molecule of NADH plus H plus is formed. When it enters the electron transport chain, 3 for one molecule of NADH, 3 molecules of ATP is formed. Okay, so then from one molecule of glucose, 2 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate is formed. So we have to multiply this reaction. From now we have to multiply every one into 2. Okay, every reaction into 2. Okay, see here, 2 molecules of glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate forms them. 2 molecules of 1,3 bisphosphate glycerate and releases the 2 molecules of NADH, and these 2 molecules of NADH release it into the electron transport chain to give them 2 into 3, that is 6 molecules of ATP. This is about this reaction. Next, the enzyme phosphoglycerate kinase acts on 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate, resulting in the synthesis of ATP and formation of 3 phosphoglycerate. This step is a good example of substrate level phosphorylation, since ATP is synthesized from the substrate without the involvement of electron transport chain. Phosphoglycerate kinase reaction is reversible, a rare example among the kinase reactions. See once again, the enzyme phosphoglycerate kinase acts on 1,3 phosphoglycerate, resulting in the synthesis of ATP and formation of 3 phosphoglycerate. This step is a good example of substrate level phosphorylation, since ATP is synthesized from the substrate without the involvement of electron transport chain. Phosphoglycerate kinase reaction is reversible, a rare example among the kinase reactions. 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate is converted to 3 phosphoglycerate. See once again, 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate is converted to the 3 phosphoglycerate in the presence of enzyme phosphoglycerokinate, phosphoglycerate kinase. In this reaction, this is a energy generating reaction. In this reaction, ATP is formed from ADP. ATP is formed from ATP. This reaction is dependent on the ion, magnesium ion. Okay. For the 2 molecules, 2 ATP are formed. Okay. From 1 glucose, 2 molecules of 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate are formed. So we have to multiply them each and every one with 2. Okay, 2 molecules of 1,3 bisphosphoglycerate, 2 ADP, 2 ATP are formed. Okay, and 2 molecules of 3 phosphoglycerate formed. Okay, next, 3 phosphoglycerate is converted to 2 phosphoglycerate by phosphoglycerate mutase. This is an isomerization reaction. 3 phosphoglycerate converted to 2 phosphoglycerate by enzyme glucose phosphoglucuronate mutase. Phosphoglycerate mutase. This is an isomerization reaction. 3 phosphoglycerate is converted to 2 phosphoglycerate. This is an isomerization reaction. In the presence of enzyme phosphoglycerate mutase, the high energy compound phosphoenol pyruvate is generated from 2 phosphoglycerate by the enzyme enolase. This enzyme requires the magnesium ion or manganese ion and is inhibited by fluoride. For blood glucose estimation in the laboratory, fluoride is added to the blood to prevent the glycolysis by the cells, so that blood glucose is correctly estimated. Fluoride combines with magnesium and phosphate to form a complex that binds with active sites of enolase and blocks access of substrate. Thus, fluoride is an unusual competitive inhibitor. 2 phosphoglycerate is converted to the phosphoenol pyruvate. 2 phosphoglycerate is converted to the phosphoenol pyruvate in the presence of enzyme enolase. Okay, and this reaction is dependent on the ion, magnesium ion, and one molecule of H2O is released. Okay, two phosphoglycerate is converted to the phosphoenol pyruvate. In the presence of enzyme enolase, this reaction is dependent on magnesium ion and one molecule of water is released. Next, the enzyme pyruvate kinase catalyzes the transfer of a high energy phosphate from phosphoenol pyruvate to ADP, leading to the formation of ATP. This step is also a substrate level phosphorylation. This reaction is irreversible. The enzyme pyruvate kinase catalyzes the transfer of high energy phosphate from phosphoenol pyruvate to ADP, leading to the formation of ATP. This step is also a substrate level phosphorylation. This is the substrate level phosphorylation reaction. This reaction is irreversible. See here, phosphoenol pyruvate is converted to the pyruvate in the presence of enzyme pyruvate kinase. Okay, and from here, this reaction is dependent on magnesium ion. In this reaction, the pyruvate present in the phosphoenol pyruvate is transferred to ADP. The phosphate that is present in the phosphoenol pyruvate is transferred to the ADP and is converted to the ATP. Okay, actually two molecules of phosphoenol pyruvate is present from one molecule of glucose, so we have to multiply here with 2. Okay, from two phosphoenol pyruvate molecules, 2 ATP are formed. Okay, this is the reaction. Next, first the formed pyruvate is enol form. Okay, first the formed pyruvate is in enol form, and this reaction is spontaneously converted to the pyruvate keto form. Okay, pyruvate is converted from enol form to keto form. This is a spontaneous reaction. And from pyruvate, with the help of enzyme lactate dehydrogenase, L-lactate is formed. Okay, this is energy consumer reaction. Pyruvate is converted to lactate in the presence of enzyme lactate dehydrogenase. Okay, this is about the glycolysis pathway. Glucose to glucose 6-phosphate in the presence of enzyme hexokinase or glucokinase, and glucose 6-phosphate is converted to fructose 6-phosphate in the presence of enzyme phosphohexokinase isomerase, and fructose 6-phosphate is converted to fructose 1,6-bisphosphate in the presence of enzyme phosphofructokinase. Up to here, this is the energy investment phase. Here 1 ATP, here 1 ATP, that means 2 ATP are consumed. Next, fructose 1,6-bisphosphate is converted to dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. This is an splitting phase, and the enzyme utilized here are aldolase. Next reaction is isomerization. In this reaction, phosphotriose isomerase is the enzyme. It converts the this enzyme is used in interconversion of dihydroxyacetone phosphate and glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. Next, from here, energy generation phase, and from one molecule of glucose, two molecules of glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate. So from here, we have to multiply every reaction with 2. Okay, glyceraldehyde 3-phosphate is converted to 1, 3 bisphosphoglycerate with the help of enzyme glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate dehydrogenase and 1 molecule of NADH is released. Okay, don't forget, from here we have to multiply with every reaction with 2. Okay, next 2 means from 1 NADH 2 molecules of ATP are formed. So 2 into 3, 6 molecules of ATP are formed, okay, in electron transport chain. Next, from 1, 3 bisphosphoglycerate is converted to 3 phosphoglycerate in the presence of enzyme phosphoglycerate kinase. And from here, again 1 ATP is released. Once again, remember, here 1 ATP means we have to multiply with 2. Okay, we have to multiply with 2. That means there 6. Here 6 ATP. Next, plus 2. Okay, that means 6 plus 2, 8. Next, see here, this 3 phosphoglycerate is converted to 2 phosphoglycerate in the presence of enzyme phosphoglycerate mutase. Okay, next, 2 phosphoglycerate is converted to phosphoenol pyruvate in the presence of enzyme enolase. And from here, phosphoenol pyruvate is converted to pyruvate in the presence of enzyme pyruvate kinase. And here 2 molecules of ATP are formed. That means I am just multiplied with 2. Okay, that means 8 plus 2, 10. Okay, in total 10, in energy generation phase, totally I also added the ATP that come from NADP in electron transport chain. Okay, in totally energy generation phase, 10 ATP are formed. Okay, next, in energy investment phase, 2 ATP are utilized. Okay, 10 minus 2, that is 8 ATP totally. Okay, this is the net. That means 2 NADPH plus 2 ATP. Okay, this is about the glycolysis reaction. Next, this pyruvate first formed is enol form, and it spontaneously this enol form pyruvate is converted to pyruvate keto form. Next, this pyruvate is converted to the lactate. Okay, with the help of enzyme lactate dehydrogenase, and this reaction is energy dependent phase. That means NADH is utilized. I just told them about the energy up to here. In this reaction, that NADP formed it before is cancelled. Okay, and the remaining and the energy remain here is 2 ATP. Okay, totally ATP formed are 4. ATP utilized in energy investment phase, 2. 4 ATP minus 2 ATP, totally 2 ATP are remain. Okay, 2 ATP are remain because NADH formed before is cancelled here, cancelled in this reaction, in the reaction pyruvate that converted to lactate. This is about the glycolysis. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe. Thank you.